In this video, I'm going to show you the easiest way to find the mirror surface of a front surface mirror. Hi, it's Vincio with firstsurfacemirror.com. Do you need to know the difference between the mirror side and the non-mirror side? Well, keep watching to find out three simple methods that will instantly help you out. Is the laminate still on your front surface mirror? A ton of people simply forget to remove this laminate before using their front surface mirrors. If it's still on your glass, then you're in luck. First surface mirrors are shipped with a protective blue laminate to protect the mirror surface. The protective laminate is an easy way to tell which side is the mirror side because the laminate side is always the mirror side. Now, what if you took the laminate off and you can't seem to remember which side of the glass is the mirror side? Just try the simple trick. Take a pen and hold it up to the mirror. If it touches its reflection, then that means it is the mirror side. If you're holding up the pen and there's a slight gap in between the reflection and itself, then that means it is not the mirror side. This is known as the fingernail test because you can also do the simple trick with your finger. Just hold it up against the glass as if it were a pen and you will get the same results determining whether or not that is the mirror side or the laminated side. On thin mirrors, it's nice to be able to double check your results. Reflect text from your cell phone or a computer printout to look for a double image. If you're seeing a double image, it's reflecting off the non-mirror side. The side with no double image is the mirror side. Next we have here is the dielectric beam splitter mirrors. They come with a reflective side, which has the tint-free mirror coating, and the back side has the anti-reflective coating to prevent a double image seen in cheaper quality glass known as ghosting. Ghosting can cause headaches and can make it very difficult to read text off ordinary glass or a two-way mirror. A teleprompter mirror has an anti-reflective backside, which eliminates the double reflection. When installing a teleprompter mirror, you want to make sure the mirror side is closer to the text side to make sure that there is no double image. To find out which side of the teleprompter mirror is the mirror side, you can also use the fingernail test to test out to see which side is the mirror side. Now let's take a look at how ghosting can affect both mirrors. First, let's take a look at the first surface mirror. The first surface mirror is opaque with 0% transparency and 96% reflective. As you can see, as we hold it up for reflection, the first surface mirror is providing a true reflection with no ghosting happening whatsoever. Cool fact! Regular mirrors have an aluminum mirror coating on the back side of the glass that can create a faint secondary reflection. The first surface mirror solves ghosting by having the mirror coating on the face of the glass, which maximizes the amount of light reflected and maximizes distortion. Next, the dielectric beam splitter mirror, aka the teleprompter mirror. The teleprompter mirror is 30% reflective and 70% transparent. The reflective side has a tint-free mirror coating, and then the back side has an anti-reflective coating to prevent ghosting. Alright guys, I hope you learned a lot from this video, and now you guys can go on with your mirror projects and not worry about damaging the wrong side of the mirror. I hope you guys enjoy the video, and if you have any questions, feel free to check out the teleprompter mirror website for more information on the mirror quality and any other product questions that you may have. Check out our other IGTV videos for all the tips and facts that we have to offer. I'm Vincia, and I'll catch you on the other side of the mirror. Bye!